Everybody on YouTube and of course also here in Twitch chat for some more Naya dinosaurs. Certainly my favorite dinosaur deck and the most successful one that I've played so far, or at least that I played throughout the Guilds of Ravnica standard season. So yeah, I think we'll just kind of get onto it. You know, we're basically playing a bigger mana ramp deck with our treasure maps and Thunderherd migrations early. The Coil and Clarions are, of course, good against aggro, and none of our creatures die to Deafening Clarion. So we're kind of a control deck in that sense of we go bigger than the aggro decks. We're using Clarion to sweep up the board. Of course, Clarion works really well with Ripjaw Raptor also. And we finish out with some Alphas and Tyrants. So let's go ahead and give it a whirl. Hey, Knight. No Zakama. The deck first started with Zakama in it, with like one Zakama and one Jissath and stuff, and just kind of moved away from those. It just cost too much mana. So Clarion does kill the Registrar Alpha tokens. So yeah, I guess it does kill that. So that's a little bit unfortunate for us. Never lucky. Opponent gets to go first. After clicking keep, I realized I did not have... Let's get this set up. I did not have red mana. So I regretted it there for a minute. But we just found red mana anyway, so we're good to go there. Alright, Steam Vents Opt. We got... Oh, a Phoenix deck. Coil's good against Phoenix. I probably need to coil this Electromancer, though. Gotta slow them down. We're playing some Golgari aggro lands before RNA. I don't think so, Nick. I don't think so. Only playing one more stream before... Or there's only one more stream before RNA, which is going to be tomorrow. Don't think I'll have Golgari aggro lands. I'm definitely playing... Naya Legends, Hadana Stompy, and Rakdos Midrange. Definitely playing those three decks tomorrow. And then the fourth deck. Still kind of up for consideration. Are we going to be able to race them? So we attack for 6 to put them down to 12. Yeah, We're certainly going to be able to race them as long as they don't get a blocker. Deafening Clarion would be a wonderful draw step for us. Because the other good part about Deafening Clarion in this deck, besides like not killing our creatures, you know, it kills that token, but whatever. The lifelink is really important. The lifelink is huge. Hey, QQ Image with the Twitch Prime sub. Thanks, Image. Oh, and Gorum with the Hadana Stompy hype. Thanks for the bits there, Gorum. First cheer of the week. Alright, so what do they do? Alright, so they did nothing else on my turn. Alright, I hope they don't have a counterspell. Or removal. Yeah, Deathcore Scavenger is a pretty good sideboard card. It's good in this matchup, but it's not necessarily something that I love in a lot of matchups. You know, its weakness, you know, it's weak against Clarion. Like, if, you know, we're playing Deafening Clarion, it'll get swept up there. So, That was a close one. But I got us, would have had us down to one, double shock. That was a close one. I may like Cannonade. Just kills those Phoenixes. Binding gets rid of stuff. Clarion's still good. Maybe we just don't have time for Treasure Map. Can take Treasure Map on out. And thrashing Lebrontodon doesn't match up too well. Do we really need the cannonades, though? I don't know. Six sweepers seems like a lot. Maybe we don't need those cannonades. Let's get another Vivian in. And a Huatli. Just Brontodon back. Huatli, like, the life gain is honestly, like, pretty nice. And, like, making some... And, like, the minus X also just dealing, like, damage to, like, some different... Drakes and things and making them not be able to block is also actually kind of nice. Huatli's really not that bad in this matchup. But I don't know if I need like more five drops. And I don't think Huatli's probably better than Vivian. So I think we're just going with this sideboard in here. Just taking out treasure maps, putting in another Clarion, more bindings, and extra Vivian. Huatli's probably better than Brontodon overall in this matchup, but with curve considerations, I don't want to have just a ton of five drops, so keeping the three drop. Yeah, if our opponent would have used the shocks, if they would have used both shocks on my Registeur Alpha that was in play, and then my other Alpha entered, I would not have been able to attack for lethal. They would have had me. We need to keep getting land drops here. So I'm playing Thunderherd Migration over playing Brontodon. Do I need a second red? Not really. Do I need a third green? Not really either. We'll get the second red. Just in case. I would like them to play a Crackling Drake here where we're just binding it. Or Electromancer. Binding that. The thing is, binding does not stop Arclight Phoenix very well. Oh yeah, we're playing a Dino deck here, Crush. Does not stop like Arclight Phoenix from entering the battlefield from their graveyard. Love Deafening Clarion as a draw there. Giving Carnage Tyrants lifelink. Very nice. Let's hopefully get a sixth land here. Play Carnage Tyrant. Yeah, they ditched a Crackling Drake because they can't cast him anymore. Alright, looks like Phoenix is going to come back. Found another Phoenix to go with another Tormenting Voice. That's a good find. All right, come on, Tyrant. Land. Ooh, that's a good land too. kill me this turn or something? Yeah, Binding works, yeah, just as well on Phoenix as any other exile removal, except for just, you know, the whole costing 4 mana thing. But yeah, besides that, it works just as well. So I've already used 2 Charter Course and 3 Tormenting Voice. Third Phoenix? Come on. 3 Phoenixes in the top half. But we're gonna need another Deafening Clarion. Gotta get that lifelink in here. Maybe I should just have cannonades in the deck. Cause cannonade, I get to attack for 7. They go to combat. I get to cast cannonade during combat, and blow those things up, and they have to wait another turn. I should just have those in. All right, if we take out Brontodons. No, I won't, Wally. Let's get 1 Brunton on there. Yeah, the Tyrants could certainly be too slow. It's definitely possible I don't need all 4 Tyrants. Certainly possible. You know, we do have the ability to ramp into them a little bit. And you know, they're not counterable, and they end games quickly, especially after Regisaur Alpha giving them haste. Yeah. Yeah, we're playing Naya Dinos without the Naya Dinosaurs. No, like I said, I don't... Like, this matchup, Deathgorge Scavenger would be good whenever they discard... You know, like, if they discard a, if they discard an Arclight Phoenix, but I don't think it's too good other places. It doesn't... I don't think it matches up too particularly well for us. Yeah, I think this would probably be a rhythm deck. Given all your creatures uncounterable would be really nice. Rhythm may replace treasure map. What? Trying to... What? Okay, nice, Angel. Alpha, attack! I think I'm most excited about Mardu. Playing like Mardu Aristocrats. So it's mostly like Rakdos and Orzhov, putting those together. Not super excited for Wilderness Reclamation. Not too excited about that one. More dinos. No, it's not a real grindy archetype. It has some grind elements, but it is a difficult one to kind of deal with because it just nickels and dimes the opponent to death with cards that aren't really worth using the removal spells on, kind of thing. And hard to kill. You sacrifice your own creatures a bunch. And there we go. Regisaur Alpha. Getting some attacking in. We are out racing Phoenix. Both games 1 and 3 there that we won. Just out racing them. And especially that game 1. You know, like our opponent had like turn 4 Phoenix, turn 5 Phoenix. And we just had turn 5 Alpha, turn 6 Alpha, and out raced them. Oh, Jund value will be really strong. Jund will be a really good deck. I mean, Golgari's already really great, and then being able to add in cards like Bedevil and Rekindling Phoenix and Siege Gang Commander and whatever else you want to put in that deck, any of the Gruul cards. Yeah, like, it's certainly going to be a really good deck. Nice. Rakdos Pure Burn. There you go. For Commander multiplayer. I'm not sure. I would go for Commander there, Philo. I would recommend going to EDH Rec. I've heard good things about the EDH Rec website, which I guess I would assume is just called EDHREC.com. I don't know. I haven't been there, but that's just like the name I've heard a lot, EDH Rec. And on there's like, you know, thousands and thousands of EDH decks and stuff, and you can kind of tell what's like real popular and things like that. So you can kind of go there and see like what tribes are popular. Yeah, our opponent mulled to 5, and I guess their 5 was really bad and they were not happy and packed it up. And they're back to 6. What's Unbreakable Formation? What does that card do? Unbreakable Formation. How can you play turn 3 Carnage Tyrant with 2 Incubation Druids and an Unbreakable Formation? That doesn't... How could that possibly work? Your second Incubation Druid doesn't have haste. Like, on turn 2, you would play an Incubation Druid. Turn 3, if you play another Incubation Druid, it doesn't have haste. It's not going to just be able to tap for anything. And you won't even have the mana to cast Unbreakable Formation also. Like, you don't just have 5 mana anyway to even cast the 2 spells. You can go with a turn 4 Carnage Tyrant. But, of course, there's already ways to be playing turn 4 Carnage Tyrant. So this is a problem with my deck. I don't have a basic planes, do I? Oh, no, no, I think I do have a basic planes, don't I? Wait, I should have one basic planes. But my deck list doesn't, command doesn't update. Oh, well, I'm still just casting this. Yeah, I have one planes, never mind. Okay, good. Yeah, we're good, we have a planes. That's, Naya Value doesn't have a planes. This one has one. Yeah, no, it was just kind of bad luck for us. We just lost to Golgari twice. We just got finality to bunch and everything. We were certainly in the games and stuff. We just didn't pull out the matches with Orzhov Knights earlier. What's my favorite deck to pilot? Certainly one of the Legends decks that I've put together. Probably Naya Legends. Yeah, I think Naya Legends. No, playing really bad cards like Gird for Battle and stuff like that is not a good way to make your deck better. I would not play those with Incubation Druids. It's better to play good cards like Hadana's Climb. So I need a Clarion here. But I also need this Experimental Frenzy out of here. Taking Frenzy out.
Would you like to see what's left of Scott?
If they kill Vivian, we take 8 and go to 5. Or a Johnny Adversary of Tyrants, which can minus and put Incubation Druid back into play, or can just plus and put counters on him. Oh no, Dauntless Bodyguard. That's a problem. So that's saving a knight token. So now Clarion doesn't even kill too much stuff. Alright, all at me, huh? What am I looking for? A second Clarion? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 3. I guess I could have Bronzodon plus Clarion. Now it's survive. I think that's just a better chance. I don't think I should scry here. I think I may need that mana. There we go. There's Brontodon. Or I just can't shock and survive.
The wilds are my shield.
With taking the land here that we get to tap, that means we get to activate Treasure Map next turn. Alright, so we can go to 1. With, if we're able to block the Knight Token, we take 2 here, go to 1. Hopefully our opponent got a land, because they have so many cards to kill us. Okay, not dead. Still not dead. Could certainly use another Clarion. Do I want to destroy this History Benalia? No.
You can't stop nature.
We attack for next turn. 15, 18, 21. We get attack for 21 next turn. With just playing Carnage Tyrant. Alright, Deafening Clarion. One time. Dang. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five. So I need a green source.
I've seen things that would break someone like you.
I can't pay two life for a green source. Needed an untapped green source to be able to play both cards. Oh yeah, if our opponent draws basically anything, it's GG. The update is really good. It's a really, really nice update for players. Yeah, you're not able to pay two life when you don't have two life to pay. If I was at two, I could pay two life, so it would ask me to pay two life. If I would like, you know, it asked me if I would like to pay two life if I was at two, but not at one. So 64. I'm just going to take bindings out. They're pretty expensive. This looks good. Yeah, the reinforcements have haste, yeah. Heroic reinforcements makes 2/1/1 creatures, and then all your creatures get +1/+1 and gain haste until end of turn. Yeah, we just brought in 3 more sweepers to help out with this matchup. I'm feeling pretty good that we're going to get game 3 here. Forgot this is game 3 even. Forgot that we just won the first game for free. I don't think the vault is changing, but the changes so you cannot open a fifth card kind of thing, that's not changing until they update. Like, there will be an update on Thursday. It's not gonna, you know, like, they think they'll update it. I think they may take it down for a little bit to update it or whatever, but I think that's when they said that'll be updated is on Thursday. Yeah. Yeah, certainly good to hold your packs. I wish I would have held my Guilds of Ravnica packs, because there's barely any Guilds of Ravnica rares that I need. And, you know, we opened 3 packs from yesterday for getting those. If I would have just waited on those. Of course, you know, we didn't know. Yeah, I guess it's called White Weenie due to small creatures. I don't really know where that saying came from. Reptile Raptor is going to be pretty good in this matchup, unless they have a exile removal spell for it. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow are my three last runs with different decks. Playing 12 decks that, you know, four a day that I've been enjoying throughout Guilds of Ravnica season. It's been my last run with each of these 12 decks. Then Wednesday, I'm going to be taking the day off. Thursday, I'll be doing a 12-hour stream from 11 to 11 Eastern with the new set. Plan sealed.
Wild animals I like.
Maybe better to tick up.
Not so much.
If I minus, they have another tribunal for the Ripjaw Raptor. Kill Vivian. I'm not doing so good. If I tick up, they just Conclave Tribunal the Vivian, and then I'm still not doing very good.
That can't help you now.
I'm just gonna minus. Possibly playing Dimir Kwazi. Not sure. I know I'm going to play Rakdos Midrange, Hadana, Stompy, and Jeskai Legends. Or sorry, and Naya Legends tomorrow. Nothing's in the donation queue at all.
You have to do better than that.
With playing four leagues every single day, I've been really good at just playing every single deck like that gets donated for basically right away. Haven't had a queue in a real long time. So I did have the tribunal. So I kind of wish I would have ticked up with Vivian. Then they would Tribunal Vivian, but I'd still have the extra card. That's a good card. Good job, Carnage Tyrant. Way to be big. Now we just need Deafening Clarion to give it lifelink and wipe their battlefield. I should probably just kill the Hunted Witness, honestly. Yeah, I think I should just coil the Hunted Witness. All right, we got rid of the frenzy. Come on. Hey. Okay. Do I do this now, or do I wait a turn? Guess I do it now. Yeah, I really should have coiled that Hunted Witness before. Put him down to 9. No, Maritime. I think it'd be probably just best to wait for the new set. You know, I'm just kind of going through like these 12 decks here.
I understand you are in need of support.
And yeah, if you not sure if you can stay awake, it'd be better. I'd rather you be awake and everything. Hey, Wolfmaster. Good evening. Yep, looks real bad for us.
See in yourself what I see in you.
I needed to tick up. My big mistake this game was ticking down Vivian and not ticking up Vivian. Because my next cards were like 3 lands and a... Well, that's good. Next cards were like 3 lands and a Carnage Tyrant. And I would have just got that Carnage Tyrant with the tick up. Yeah... We're not out of it, though. We're not out of it yet. Okay, let's... Good against Regisaur Alpha, nothing else in the deck. That's a good turn. Yeah, that's what Experimental Frenzy does. Just every single turn is just so many creatures. Oh no, that's kind of a normal.
There's more work to do.
Normal Frenzy there. I think we're just taking lethal here. Three, seven. Yeah, we're just taking lethal. Dang. I just tried to destroy the Experimental Frenzy with Brontodon and they had another one. So where are my top 2 or 3 favorite decks this expansion? I think Naya Legends, Naya Value, and I'd have to say Selesnya Angels, even though it wasn't the last like month or two, just the beginning of the format really liked it so much. Frenzy's a much more powerful card than Risk Factor. Like on its, you know, just side by side, but risk factor can, you know, risk factor is obviously good with a whole lot of other burn spells. The problem is risk factor can't win games by itself. Whenever you have like a weak hand, risk factor is not going to win a game for you, where frenzy can win games for you. Yeah, so, all right, new game. This time, I need to tick up Vivian instead of tick down. That was the play that cost me that game. So we would have just had the Carnage Tyrant earlier and the Clarions. We would have got to those earlier and everything. Selesnya Guildgate. So, likely looking at tokens, which of course Clarion is great there. There wasn't really anything, so I could have had Upkeep Scry, but there wasn't really anything that I necessarily needed to draw into, so I didn't think it was worth it to go Upkeep Scry. I think we could just take the draw step and kind of get more information about everything before deciding what to do there. All right, let's get that thing off the battlefield. That's Slimefoot. Hey, we got another sub. Let's keep this hype going for Pouty. Thanks for the support there, Pouty. All right, so that gets to 14 on the day. So one more, and we're adding another pack to our Ravnica pack counter. So I do need to use a treasure, but I think it's worth it to flip the treasure cove, even though it costs one of my treasures to do it. And this game looks pretty over. It's how many sub goals we've hit in the last couple of days, and so therefore how many packs I'm going to be getting of Ravnica Allegiance when the set comes out. No, I don't. Oh, sorry to answer a question from before. I don't sleep wearing a tie. Most of the time. Nah. Dinosaurs! My opponent said GG. What? Why was that bad manners? My opponent said GG, so I said GG back. That's good manners. All right, there's sub number 15. Mitchin. That adds up our pack counter up to 7 now. Thanks, Kevlar. All right, so we're playing against some tokens. Probably want these cannonades in here. And this other Clarion. We'll get a Waddles. Waddles is probably just fine. We'll cut some bindings. And Vivian. And no, I'm going to cut some treasure maps. There we go. Cole's just clearanced all of 2018's ties on Friday. He's got some sweet Crofton Barrow ties for like $350 each. Heck yeah. Dude, that's a good pickup. This is not one. I don't remember the brand I really liked for ties at Kohl's. I think it started with an A, I think. I think this tie over here that I was wearing yesterday that I still have right over here. I think this is one. Apt 9. Yeah, I like a lot of the Apt 9 ties from Kohl's. I guess that's probably Apartment 9. Yeah, Allegiance is supposed to be available at 11 a.m. Eastern on Thursday. Probably don't need all these lava coils in my deck. I could have probably trimmed some of them. Now I'm going to be upkeep scrying because we know that I want to find Clarions. Clarions or cannonades. I want to get those kind of sweepers. So, I'm going to upkeep Scry to look for those. Ugh, Thunderherd Migration. Well, it's a card I can play here. That'll allow me to play Registrar Alpha next turn. I mean, I'm wearing slacks, not jeans, but yeah, I find those comfortable. As a monkey, I'm surprised anybody becomes human. All right, we still got one good blocker here. Let's get this upkeep scry in. What's the best deck types to start with? Mono-colored aggressive decks are the best decks to start with. So if I... That's a fungus, right? And that's just a sapling die, so I can block this fungus just fine. Good card. I guess I keep it on top. I think I want to just play. I think I just want to coil this thing though. Twilight Prophet. Our opponent likes to turn them sideways. It's too late on the upkeep stop there. So if we play Ripjaw Raptor and Lava Coil, we have just enough mana to do that. Corndog, it just lost two matches. It didn't get dumpstered so badly. It was in both the matches. It just lost to Golgari twice. Our opponents had a lot of finalities, and they killed our creatures a lot. Losing two matches in a row happens quite a bit in Magic. No... No, I'm not excited for the Bant Nexus deck. not particularly. It's gonna, I think it'll be very good, but it's not like a deck I'm excited about. Big Boss, I don't know why you just want to be so negative and insulting. I don't appreciate it, though. No, I'm not expecting anything to be banned on Monday. I wouldn't be surprised. I think I would put it at like 40% chance something gets banned. Maybe 35% chance something gets banned. 65% it doesn't. So it wouldn't like necessarily like really surprise me if something got banned. But I'm not expecting anything to, though. What could get banned? Just the same things everybody's saying. Like something from KCI being the most likely. Yeah, like most likely something from KCI. All right, we are 2-1. So yeah. The thing is, like, Stirrings goes in so many different decks. You know, you heard a whole lot of decks banning Stirrings. Holiest of Hats. Subbing there to Twitch Prime. Thank you so much, Holiest of Hats. Yes, Stoneforge Mystic is certainly safe to unban. And I expect it to be unbanned at some point. I don't know if this is the time or not, but it'll be unbanned at some point. Thanks, Holiest. Hey, Neritis. All right. Migration. Get another land in here. Doing good color wise. Just get another green source. Hey, thanks, Joe. Yeah, I really like the Naya Legends deck too. We're playing that one tomorrow for sure. And I'm gonna start scrying with this treasure map over playing the other treasure map. That's unfortunate. All right, keeping the land. Time to start attacking. Whoa! We're getting 10 gifted subs, courtesy of Neritis. Everybody get your hype boats in the channel. That certainly gets a bunch of hype. Thanks, Neritis. Thank you. So that gets us to 26. That gets two more packs added. All right, and we are... we are actually only... All right, if you're enjoying the stream and like to subscribe, also, this is a wonderful time, too, now, because with this help with what we've gone through today here, being a 26, we are only now 28 more subscribers away from a new emote.
Draw.
So the closest
fire.
we've been to the new emote. Yeah, we are. I guess I could have a counter there. We do a new emote counter. I think that may reset. I think that number is going to go down quite a bit because, like a month ago, we had a lot of gifted subs.
Let's see if you're worthy. This is nothing.
How many have been renewing my gifts? Not many. Yeah, not too many. I think we only had one renew. Yeah, it's not very common to have renew.
So it's going to be like
okay.
That, huh?
All right, so I'm just killing their Vivian and keeping my Alpha back to block for my Vivian. Yeah, right now, still a lot of my subs right now, Neritis, are your gifted subs, honestly.
No one knows the wilds like I do.
No, the avatar doesn't matter in terms of gameplay, no. So we can... I'm going to take Brontodon. Because I want to be able to play something and activate this treasure map. I want to be able to activate the treasure map. Still, also. Do I attack on in there? Get in there for three? Oh, thanks, Neritis. The Knights lost... to Golgari a couple of times. They got finality'd a bunch.
Scars.
All right, Vivian down.
Written in skin.
So that's 4, 8. So if I attack with everything, we deal 11. They go down to 2. They just block, like, 2 dinos. Hey, hot outside today. Whew! So many Registrar Alphas. Next turn, we have the mana because of these treasures. We have the mana to cast both of these Registrar Alphas. All 4 Registrar Alphas. They did. Ugh. All right, okay, I'm gonna put you on my lap so I can do a little bit of typing. Thanks, okay. All right, let's get another Clarion in. I don't want Fiery Cannonade here. So they're playing Benelish Marshal with Angels and Vivians. Hmm. Ugh. Okay, you're pulling down my tie. No, Hawkeye's named after the Iowa Hawkeyes. I think I want extra Vivian. Bindings, though, if they're playing, you know, Knight of Autumns, Vivian's, Binding's just not going to be very reliable, so we're going to trim on Binding there. And I think that's our only change. Do I want Huatli also? Do we want Huatli? Maybe we're Treasure Map. Yeah, actually, Treasure Map just kind of dies to the other things also. Actually, yeah, let's get Huatli and Awakening Sun's Avatar. I guess I can't really cut Treasure Map if I'm playing Awakening Sun's Avatar, though. I need Treasure Map for that, so maybe not. All right. Just that. No, Hawkeye doesn't really actually like other cats and animals and stuff. Doesn't get along with them too well. He likes me a lot, though, so... He's certainly glad that I'm not traveling all the time. No, I'm actually a Steelers fan. The thing is, the deck, I play a whole lot of spells for Commune with Dinosaurs. I mean, Vivian Tick Up is just Commune with Dinosaurs itself. Alright, I don't want to use a Lava Coil on a Tecali Honor Guard. It's only good against just half of Registrar Alpha. I'm saving Lava Coils for more important things like that Resplendent Angel. Oh, the match score is Neritis 2, Todd 0. Oh, yeah, you beat me with Jeskai twice, haven't you? Do I coil that or play Labrontodon? I'll play Labrontodon. Yeah, because the Steelers have the same colors as the Hawkeyes, the black and gold. Yeah, so we got to do our own sideboarding. I really don't like having to do like the old your own sideboarding and make new decks and everything like that. I think I coil now. No fight spell in here. Now they have Dawnbringer. Nope, no Dawnbringer. What do they got going on over there? I'm gonna play this Huatli. Start making some dinos with that.
Go and your feast on their flesh. History.
But yeah, I'm of course definitely open to, for more of the challenges, though, Neritis. Okay. Huh. What's our opponent doing over there? What are they doing? Like Cleansing Nova or something?
Sing the song of fame.
Yeah, I guess it could be March. Could be Cleansing Nova. I think I just want to draw a card with Archer Araska here. Over doing anything else.
Okay.
was Nova. Called it.
Go and feast on their flesh.
And, I'm certainly, like, considering, like, taking up the Huali just to get it to 5 loyalty where it can kill something, but just like the minus X, we can still, like, just ping things so they can't block kind of thing. Yeah, the Huali was real good there against Nova. Huali was actually just really good for us that game. Oh, no, we didn't get to see it. I clicked it too fast. I was all excited. It was a rare. I clicked it too fast. We didn't get to see what rare was. All right, Naya Dinos, 3-1. Serrano! Getting that storm count to 27. We're the halfway there now. 27 subs and 27 subs away from an emote now. Alright, I like keeping this on the play. Just ramping into alpha. Hopefully we draw some more dinosaurs. Yeah, Huali doesn't see very much play. Yeah, Vivian is taking the spotlight. We have Huali in the sideboard here. Well, we could have turn 4 Carnage Tyrant if we draw a Carnage Tyrant. Ooh, Molder Hulks. Oh, don't draw land. It's the worst draw. So we've got 25 lands in this deck. Yeah. We got 8 of them out. 8 of the lands out of the 11 cards we've seen so far. So hopefully we draw a bunch of spells now. There we go. That's a good start. And I don't want to attack with my dinosaur there because I don't really want them to trade. This kind of deck is not really a good one for me to have a bunch of creatures in the graveyard. For so they're at 3 right now. I guess I do just block though. All right, good. No finality. Do you think the next set will get all the Gatewatch?
The wild wasn't meant to be contained.
Well, are they trophying?
I've seen squirrels hit harder. Come to me.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. No attacks. Yeah, the Gatewatch is not disbanded yet. Like, it's, you know, like, story, like, we're not going to get the cards. We're not going to get just, like, tons of Gatewatch Planeswalkers as far as the cards are considered. Oh, is that Vraska? Oh, no. Beating Vraska is going to be difficult. Well, that's a start. Vivian, I need you to find another
things that would break
creature to
like
play
you.
Here. We don't get to play another creature here, but if they have land Vraska, they get to minus kill Regisaur Alpha and then kill Vivian, which that's bad for me. Hoping they don't have land. They do, and they didn't shock it in. Okay, so they're just going to have Golgari Raiders to kill that. Huh. All right, I get to keep my Regisaur Alpha.
I'm a survivor.
Just playing the Carnage Tyrant mostly because it costs more mana.
I despise tyrants like you. I'll destroy all that you hold precious.
That's a good draw. We just got all of our lands out of our deck. And now we're just drawing all sorts of sweet spells. So far, good city. All right, they're down two. So they can, they have six creatures in their yard. So they're going to want to, so they can have Vraska minus on red, like this game's not over yet. They have Vraska minus on Regisaur Alpha. Oh, well, now it's kind of over. Unless
wild
they find Mulder,
like people, not so much.
Mulder Hole costs six and two, seven and two.
Meet my newest friend.
I mean, they could have just follied back Mulder Hole and played it, right? Yeah. Oh, they found another one. Oh, they're real lucky. Vraska's going to make a treasure, and so they get to play this other one. Wow, they got real lucky to find another Mulder Hulk. That's like the only thing they could find. Because that extra treasure gives them exactly enough mana. Yeah, it's not so great for us now. Not so great for us now.
The wilds are my shield.
Hey, okay. Hey. So Deafening Clarion is still certainly a card I'd really like to see. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to cast Carnage Tyrant. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with that. Okay, so I cannot activate Arch and cast Carnage Tyrant and activate Treasure Map. So let's just activate Arch. If we draw land, then we get to Treasure Map as well. Okay, that's a great draw. That likely will end the game next turn. Clear out a lot of blockers and put damage on those Mulder Hulks. Like, with us having 14 trample on the battlefield with these two Carnage Tyrants, dealing three to, like, that's likely going to end the game. Oh, is it just lethal this turn? Well, I guess it's just lethal this turn. I was just, you know, just focused on the next turn and talking through how it was going to be lethal the next turn when it was just lethal this turn. Didn't even need to wait till next turn. Narinen, making everything better. Hey, thanks for the resub for the fourth month in a row there, Narinen. Well, we need another one. I don't think I should cast the second one. Well, if our opponent did not attack with the Raiders, they're still dying. They still only have, what, 7, 10? Like, it didn't matter whether they attacked with that Raiders or not. Cast both. Yeah, you're in the way. All right, we're up a game. Good old Carnage Tyrant plus Deafening Clarion. Pretty strong. Here, where's this pen? So you can play with the pen. You can stop biting me. Here you go. 28 subs on the day. Honor Guard, pretty great. They have these Planeswalkers that are a problem. Binding would be, like, awesome in this matchup if it wasn't for their Planeswalkers. Wasn't for Vivian and Vraska. Hawkeye's just American Short Tail. Just their most common cat in America. Or short hair, sorry. American Short Hair, not Short Tail. Short hair. He does have a short tail, but... do we want to play bindings? I'll just put them in. So that's 66. Just taking out these treasure maps again. Maybe I just take out Clarion. Because it kills Honor Guard. Let's try this. Oh yeah, we're playing Regisaur Alpha. Bringing White Avatar against other Golgari. We'll kind of see how this game goes. If they're trying to go bigger with like their own Carnage Tyrants, then I would certainly want White Dino. I know, of course, White Dino does not kill Carnage Tyrant, but I'm just saying if they're slowing their deck down like that. So the problem with playing other Sacred Foundry untapped in this right there is that if we draw Thrashing Brontodon, we won't have double green for it. So I'm playing the Sun Petal Grove to leave open the possibility of having another green mana for Thrashing Brontodon. Yeah, just mana consideration, just color considerations for no Arch and Naya Legends. I don't... Like, the Thunderherd migrations help me hit different colors in this deck and everything, but... Yeah, it's a color consideration thing. Wait. Get this forest in. And... Ripjaw. Crowl Foragers. Vivian Reed. All right, so this turn I'm just going to be lava coiling the Jade Light Ranger. Could just play my own Vivian right now. Next turn I'm going to be binding their Vivian Reed. Really don't want to draw more Vivians.
Which you can't stop nature.
Yeah, we'll have to see, Joic. I'm not as sold on Rhythm of the Wild as a lot of other people. But we'll see. All right, bindings are awful. Bindings awful. Treasure maps back in. What else? Get these avatars in here. All right, let's try that. So, yeah, we have planeswalkers in our deck that Immortal Sun shuts off, and usually making our creatures just a tiny bit bigger, like Immortal Sun does, isn't necessarily the, you know, it's our creatures are already 3, 4, 4, 5, 7, 6, you know, like they're already big. Of course, Immortal Sun would help, but. Really, it's just kind of how good Vivian is, you know? Like, we're just playing lots of Vivians because that card is just so ridiculously good, and it's kind of hard to play Vivian and Immortal Sun in the same deck. All right, we need more lands. Yeah, there's so many good enchantments, not only currently in the format, but also that will be in the format after Ravnica Legions, that it is not looking great for. Grixis is a color that can't deal with enchantments. All right, so the opponent was on 6 as well. Ooh, milled over 2 Molder Hulks. All right, we gotta hit this 5th land drop. We missed our first draw here. Hopefully this draw gets it for us. Gotta get this 5th one. Certainly gonna be in a much rougher spot if we don't draw this land. All right, they milled over another Molder Hulk and a Vivian. Ah, 3 lands there. Want them to keep milling over good spells. Yeah, that's probably going to be the difference in the game there. Like, if we get to play Registrar Alpha or Vivian here, you know, we're just looking much better. Okay. They didn't do anything to punish us. So didn't do any attacking there because it's so much better for them to have a lot of creatures in their graveyard. It's so much easier to cast their Molder Hulks. They could be trying to get back here. We have Finality. Alright, I guess I'm not going to play the other Red Shore Alpha into Finality. Alright, no creatures, no creatures. All right, well, now it doesn't matter. They got eight creatures. So Golgari Raiders would be a 7-7, but they can get back Molder Hulk, and it's only going to cost two mana. Oh, yeah, they did chump block the wrong thing, didn't they? Yeah, now they can Memorial the Folly. Not even falling. Okay. Foragers. Alright, I want Vivian on the battlefield, and I want to be able to tick up, hit a land drop. Whew, that was close. Almost did not get the land drop. Alright, we got them down to one. Alright, 4-1. Naya Dinos picking up the win. Yeah, Hawkeye. Naya Dinos got a win. Yet another one. 4-1. Registrar Alpha into Carnage Siren. Pretty good. Pretty good. Final boss time. Final boss time. I'm going to go ahead and just do a reset here. It's been getting pretty laggy. Been on for close to 5 hours. Let's do a quick reset. You guys, Jeskai Control. I'm going to guess Blue-Black or Grixis Control. Gonna be bold. It's gonna say a mirror match. Nice. Oh, mono blue tempo. It's the next guess. Yeah, this was certainly one of the best standard sense cons. Yep. Absolutely. Absolutely. Alright, Rex has Golgari, Random Jank, Rainbow Lich, Dimir, Vulnerable God going with me. That's what, yep, going with my guess. Another Jeskai Control guess. No Soul, Mono Red. Alright, Spell Slinger Shields. I'll keep turn two treasure map against this Grixis player. Oh, it's Golgari. Lame. My upkeep's crying. I just want to not draw a land. Anything else I was kind of okay with. Thunderherd Migration counts as a land. This is a good final boss. Let's see if our opponent keeps this Rass's Contempt. All right, they're keeping it. I want a Deafening Clarion to kill these things. Alright, let's put a bunch of lands on the bottom. This is kind of the problem with Thunderherd Migration. Is like after you scry a bunch, you know, you don't want to like shuffle these things back in, so the migration like ends up being pretty bad for you. Still gonna cast it though. It's just worth it to cast it and get the extra mana. But it's also just pretty awkward. Yeah, it's still worth the ramping, but it's just kind of awkward. All right, Clarion? Nope. Clarion? Coil's better than a random card. I like coiling the Jade Light Ranger. Oh no, migration's been pretty good for us overall. You know, like playing like alphas and Carnage Tyrants earlier has certainly been good for us. Alright, and that's the card I'm gonna binding.
I've lost so much already. I won't.
I am very glad that was not Carnage Tyrant from our opponent, though.
Fire.
Yeah, Grim, that was Neritis gifting out some subs. Alright, let's. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and binding. And so I'm gonna use one treasure to get Ripjaw Raptor in play. Yeah, because if they do Contempt Ripjaw Raptor, that's them using like their turn to cast Contempt and everything. So that's worth it. Cast down. That's a bummer. Detection Tower is also a bummer, so even if I find Carnage Tyrant, it's not going to be safe from this Contempt. Let's draw a card. I'm playing Ripjaw again first. Hoping to find Clarion. I wanted to be able to play Ripjaw, then Clarion. And kill these and draw a card. Come on, Clarion. Reggie doesn't save us. Not with contempt. Dang. So close, yet so far away. Alright, get these honor guards in here. Awakening Sun. Brontodon comes on out. One Ripjaw. Couple Thunder Herds. Probably just need all the Thunder Herds. Yeah, they saw a lot of lands and treasure maps. All right, let's try again. Yeah, they saw Migration and Ripjaw Raptor. Yeah, they saw a few things. Binding. Not gonna ship it, but the hand's slow. Can we get one of our four Tekkali Honor Guards? I'd love to draw a Tekkali Honor Guard. Honor Guard. Okay, hey, Thunderherd Migration doing something. See, it's good. Forget the Plains, because that's our third white source in case we get to Awakening Sun's Avatar. Yeah, when you lose, you get to choose if you'd like to play first or second for the other game. Awesome. No explore. No land. For no explore. Oh, baby. No removal for Reggie. Just get to Carnage Tyrant next turn. Nice. Guild Gate. That's what dinos do. They smash. Reggie gon' give it to you. Alright, so there's the Jade Light. I don't think it was a bad keep. Like, if my opponent had Forest, Swamp, Wild Growth Walker, Jade Light Ranger, and they're on the draw with seven cards, that's a good keep. They just got really unlucky to not draw any lands. I don't know why they're conceding there. They're at 9 life. They actually had the battlefield kind of, like, they were okay. They were at 9. Yeah, what's scarier than a Carnage Tyrant? Carnage Tyrant with haste. So yeah, we've played lots of Carnage Tyrants with haste here. Last league, we got two Niv-Mizzets in play at the same time. So that was pretty awesome. Go Tekkali Honor Guard. You know, obviously I wish we could have had this Clarion out before, but just can't. Alright, not the worst for us. Not the worst. Get a nice 2-for-1 here. They're down to 3 cards in hand with just 3 lands. Not so bad. Kind of a problem is we have too many lands. Yep. RNA will be on Arena on Thursday. No chup, no chup, no chup. Wow. That is even worse than chup. Alright, let's draw one of our Vivians. Kill that Elishborn. Discarding Migration. So they draw 2 cards, we draw 1 card. I mean, I have 4 lava coils that deal with Midnight Reaper. You know, we didn't have them in my hand, of course. So we'll see what they get. They get some good choices with this Eldritch Reborn minus. They can take my Ripjaw Raptor or their Jade Light or Midnight Reaper. So they got some good choices. Okay, yeah, they're taking my Ripjaw. Which makes sense. Awakening Sun does cost 8 mana, so we need 2 more lands still for Awakening Sun. Oh yeah, Midnight Reaper is a great card, for sure. Unfortunately, Carnage Tyrant not doing as much for us with the Detection Tower from my opponent. Okay. We got 1 land. 1 more for Awakening Sun. We can take out this Wild Growth Walker Jade Light Ranger package they got going on over here. All right, well, I'm certainly waiting a turn, because next turn they get to do both of those. Wow. So even if we draw a land, I'm waiting a turn. Nah, it doesn't get Ripjaw. But they're going to be at, you know, a million life. It's 34. Cast down kills Carnage Tyrant. Huh. Yet they didn't keep it. Alright, yeah, land please. Land please. And boom. Boom goes the dynamite. Upkeep stop. I think they forgot about their... no, Vivian. Ugh. Come on. Vivian. No attacks. Gotta be able to hold back to try to attack this Vivian.
Mm.
Let's tear this place apart. You can't stop nature.
I wouldn't have been surprised either way if our opponent went plus or minus there. That looks good enough to me. Hey, Ricklin, games are going good. Which card do you recommend to craft between Treasure Map and Search for Iskanta in general? Probably Search for Iskanta. Whoa. Why would I just use a treasure? So we both
strike
draw.
Me, and you strike me. Now we're getting started.
Sure. Gotta stop those chupacabras. So they get three cards, but I have a... I have a treasure map. That's an annoying one. I just get back. I can just get back Vivian or a Carnage Tyrant. Can we get a Vivian? Come on, Vivian. Vivian. Dang. I'm just gonna have to discard this coil. And, you know, I'm at 11. It's not beneficial to me to attack here. Come on, Vivian. Vivian. What is that? How are we still drawing lands? We've got like all the lands out of our deck already. What is this? Eldest Reborn just killing us. Their two Eldest Reborns were just so good.
Let's see if you're worthy. No one knows the wilds like I do.
Gross. This one's looking bad. Looking real bad. I mean, that just trades with Carnage Tyrant. Let's play that to be able to trade with Carnage Tyrant. It doesn't kill Honor Guard, of course, because it doesn't actually have an ETB effect, so it doesn't kill my Honor Guard.
That can't help you now.
Oh, yeah, I should just double block there. So how are we doing on lands here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, this Vivian certainly could be too late. But we'll see. We can start getting a bunch of dinos, alphas, friend. Carnage Tyrants, that kind of stuff. We got a whole lot of those. I mean, we're in a good spot here. They got Vivian, we got Vivian, we have Carnage Tyrant. Thanks, Sir One Delver. Alright, so what have we seen so Come far? We've seen one Carnage Tyrant, now two Tyrants, zero Alphas. We've gone through both Wakening Sun's avatars. So we still have four Alphas and two more Carnage Tyrants in the deck, as far as like big things to tick up for Vivian. No, I don't have any Zakamas. It's usually just too hard to cast. It costs so much mana, it's just stuck in your hand too often. This is certainly a time where that would be...
The wilds are my shield.
You know, where that wouldn't be the case. So Reggie, of course, isn't nearly as good with Honor Guard in play. But still worth it. I mean, so my best plan right now is to ultimate Vivian. That's my best plan. And that's what I'm going towards. Alright, what's that folly getting? Another Tyrannosaurus Rex. We found
Balance
our third.
Comes.
All right, come on, Vivian. One more turn. No contempt. No contempt. How many contempts have they seen? One, two, three, four. They've already drawn all four contempts, right? One, two. 3-4, yeah, they've already drawn all four contempts. If they have Chupacabra... If they have Chupacabra, this attack means all my things die. Or this block means all my things die. Maybe I let Vivian take one and block like this, and Vivian takes one. No. Actually, let's block like this. Yeah, the economy changes look real good. Alright, so Honor Guard's my one creature that survives. Come on, draw a creature here, please, deck. Draw a creature, please. Draw a creature.
The wilds are my shield.
Oh my gosh. God. So many frickin' lands. Yeah, they've just gotten so many Carnage Tyrants off these two Carnage Tyrants. Just had infinite Carnage Tyrants. Yeah, that's probably what we need in our sideboard is a couple settles.
Okay, nature brings your reckoning. You can't stop nature.
Well, we know all those cards, all these cards underneath Sacred Foundry, none of those are Registrar Alpha or Carnage Tyrant. So we still have a chance to draw all those things. Hey, DJ Poly B. They have these Memorial to Follies that they just keep on getting their things back and find finalities. So that was like two Carnage Tyrants, a third, a fourth. That was just like four more Carnage Tyrants for them. All right, so we are falling to the final boss, and Naya Dinosaurs has gone 4-2. You want to 1v1 me? Well, information about that is down below in the donation panel. How did our opponent not just attack me and kill me there? Didn't they just have lethal? Didn't our opponent just have lethal? So they're gonna have a Vivian ultimate also. Their Vivian ultimate's definitely lethal.
Scars are lessons written.
It is time.
Maybe they won't attack again. So that's 3-6. All right, 4-2. Pretty good league there for Naya Dinos. But yeah, I think y'all are right. I think the two, or let's get our prizes here first. Hey, a Hawatli.
You think they cheer for you?
That card did a lot for us. There. So I think the one change I'd make here with the Naya Dinos is I would take these cannonades out and put some settles in. Probably don't need those cannonades and settles. Yeah, that could certainly be better for the deck. I think that's worth it. But yeah, there we go. Naya Dinos. Nah, I don't think it needs Deathgorge Scavenger. Because Deathgorge Scavenger is kind of only good against Phoenix. In that case, we can still just have Settle for Phoenix. But yeah, this deck's fun. All right, 4-2, not so bad there. If you're watching this over on YouTube, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Still trying to get to 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. We're just past over 600, so we've got a long ways to go. Of course, here in Twitch chat, you can find my YouTube there, youtube.com/C/ToddStevensMTG. And where you can find all the replays there. But thanks for watching, and see you for the next one.